This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, oh, this is going to be tremendous. You folks have picked the absolute perfect day to tune in. We have a special guest in the Rhode Show kitchen today. Now, if you've ever been on the show, if you've ever been around here, you know that this is Lexi Kriss, our production assistant. She today is Chef Lexi. You're going to be cooking for us.
Yes, I'm very excited about it.
Well,
you're in for a treat.
Absolutely. You know me. I need all the help I can get in the kitchen. So you will simplify the recipe today. You're making the Monday mess.
Yes, this is named after you.
After me? I was just going to say, you see the way she snipers the jokes
sorry,
right away?
I'm sorry.
Chef Lexi, take us through the ingredients.
Okay, so we have some cellentini pasta here. This is one of my favorites. It absorbs the sauce really nicely because of the shape and the texture on there. Mm-hmm. So always pick a fun pasta, but we're going to go through and I'll tell you why this is a Monday mess, okay? So we're using pasta, chicken sausage, sun-dried tomato chicken sausage.
Okay.
I like to infuse some extra flavor, and often you can, instead of adding sun-dried tomato at your local supermarket, you can get a sausage that already has some flavor built in.
Mm-hmm.
So an easy step for you there.
All
some
right.
Spinach. We have some beans here, some chicken stock. I like low sodium when I can. Pepper, salt, extra virgin olive oil.
And we're using your phone to cook as well.
Yes, and I always like to use my phone when I cook because often I find that I want to Google something, I want to follow a recipe, and I think a lot of people, you know, just put a good case on there and bring it into the kitchen with you. So if you have any questions or aren't quite sure about what temperature something should be prepared to, there you go.
The other night I was making something in my kitchen, believe it or not, and I had some questions about what to do, flip right over to Google, and I figured it right
out. It's perfect. And the reason that this is called the Monday mess is that you can just throw everything in there. So don't be intimidated. On Monday, you're rushing around, you don't know what to make. Just take everything out and put it together for the Monday mess.
Who's better than Chef Lexi? Not only does she work for us here at the Rhode Show, she's cooking in our kitchen. Thank you for doing this. And you will, as we said, you will hold my hand.
Hold your hand.
And take me through the steps this morning as she prepares the Monday mess. You don't want to miss Chef Lexi in action. For now, back over to you. For now, let's send it back into the kitchen where Will awaits with Chef Lexi.
That's right. We're here at this counter. I hope we have all the paperwork filled out and we don't get sent to another, you know, another attendant. We're here with Chef Lexi, one of the finest restaurants in East Providence. Casa de Kriss is the restaurant. What do we need to do right now?
Sure. So we're making the Monday mess.
Monday mess.
We know everyone here on the road shows a little bit of a mess on a Monday, and maybe you guys at home. So we're making, it's a chicken sausage pasta dish, basically. So we have some sun-dried tomato chicken sausage here.
Love it.
So we're going to take it, I cut them in half, and we're just going to pinch it out of the casing and into a hot pan that has some olive oil, salt, and pepper. So
okay.
If you want to help me put some of these in here, that's the first step.
This.
And I was telling Brenden in the first segment that I like to choose a chicken sausage that's, you know, maybe not just sweet or spicy, but that has a little bit of additional flavor built
in. And I know sometimes you can buy, we're doing it this way, taking it out of the casing, but there are sometimes, if you go to the market, you can get them. You know, without
exactly.
the casing out.
Yeah, so whatever is your personal preference.
Mm-hmm.
I like to have a little fun with my food.
Sure.
So, you know, you're doing a great job here.
Thank
you. And then we'll start to break this up a little bit. I usually add a little bit of pepperoncini to it if I have it. Some of the, you know, little red pepper.
Right.
And then basically what we're going to do, we're going to let this cook down a little bit till it looks like this one here.
So you're going to break it apart too.
Yep, exactly. We're going to break it up. So if you want to even,
we'll
grab another one.
No, that's
And we'll break this one apart a little bit and, you know, add some salt and pepper.
Mm-hmm.
And then as it reduces down, we're going to add in a little bit more olive oil if you need the moisture. And then because it is the Monday mess, you know, I found some Prosecco in our fridge.
Look at you.
So we either use Prosecco or wine or, you know, white wine, whatever you have around to build the sauce.
Okay.
And then we can, you know, we'll add in some cheese. We're going to layer in some spinach and some peas.
All right, so you know what? I'm going to give that
back.
Thank
you so much.
I'm going to give that back to you, and I'm going to grab one of the... Actually, you know what? I'm going to grab this over here. Cause
yeah, that's perfect. And you can just break it right up.
Let me chop it up a little.
And then we have our water boiling here, so that's perfect. So I'm actually going to drop the pasta right now also. And I was, you know, saying before that I used a pasta here that has a little bit of texture to it, so the sauce will adhere a little bit better.
Okay.
And we'll drop that in the water and cook it till it's just al dente. I like to undercook it and let it finish cooking, you know, right
in the pan with everything else. All right,
exactly.
Sounds good to me. We're going to put this together, talk about what else Lexi is doing for the day. Back to you.
It is Monday morning, right? It's the start of the week. Chances are dinner is like the last thing on your mind. So Lexi is here to give us a recipe that's so easy to really kind of throw together.
Absolutely. And we're even calling it the Monday mess.
And named after
this guy.
Thank you.
No, but sometimes, especially after a weekend and you don't have anything prepared, or if you've ever come to my house for dinner, sometimes I just make this like last minute, just throw it together.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it has the protein, it has your starch, it has some veggies and a little bit of wine. So what else do you really need?
Perfect.
It's got it all. Absolutely.
I like that you bring up a good point, whether it's a last minute dinner for the family or all of a sudden friends are have come into town and you need to entertain. This is an easy enough one. You and Will kind of, I guess, for lack of a better term, squeezed out the sausage
from
the casing.
Exactly. And this is a sun-dried tomato chicken sausage. I like to, you know, cut down on some of the cholesterol and fat and use a chicken sausage. Thank you. So we have this here with a little bit of olive oil, salt, and pepper.
Okay.
And then we're going to add in, Mikhail, if you want to add in some beans or peas and the spinach. So you can, toss those right in. And we're just going to, you know, let it all cook together.
Nice. How am
I
doing
supervising? Do you need to fresh or frozen?
You're doing great. Fresh or frozen, yeah. If, you know, if I add fresh spinach, sometimes I like to cook it down first and then add it in, just depending on how seasoned you want it to be before it goes in. If you want to add a little bit of salt and pepper, we can go ahead and do that.
Sure. I like that, too, especially, you know, you dig it in your fridge or your freezer. Maybe you do have some frozen veggies.
Exactly.
Sitting in there, this is a good way to incorporate that.
And I know, Brenden, you're always joking that you have, you know, you're inexperienced in the kitchen, but this is a great way to sort of, you know, wet your feet.
Now, is this something, Lexi, that you have been preparing for a long time? Was this taught to you? Did you just start throwing it together?
Yeah.
How did it come about?
I mean, my mom and I always cook together, and my brother is actually also a really good cook. So we would, you know, always just be, what can we make for dinner tonight and throw in whatever we had.
Yep.
But now this has sort of become a signature dish that I have, like, amongst my friends. They're like, oh, are you going to make us the chicken and spinach pasta dish. So,
I think you need to copyright and trademark this immediately.
Done.
Lexi's Monday Mess.
Thank you, thank you.
You're
Can we add in the pasta for me, please?
Which is not fully cooked,
right? It's right. It's a little undercooked. It's al dente, which means to the tooth in Italian. So if you actually, if you want to grab a noodle there, and you're going to see that it's really, you're going to be able to bite into it and feel it.
It's a good noodle.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then we need to add a little bit of the chicken stock, please. And we'll add in a little bit of olive oil as well.
And you're going to work it all around.
Yeah, that's perfect. Perfect.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you want to give it a stir?
Oh, I would love to give it a whirl.
Mikhail's just going to add a little bit of olive oil there. Perfect. And we're going to finish it with some cheese. But here, see how easy this is. You can even just give it a spin there.
Give it a whirl.
There we go. Getting the right
and
in
then
there.
Do we add a little Prosecco too? We'll add
Why
a little
not?
Prosecco.
I mean, come on. It's Monday. Get in there.
Want to sit?
You don't have to. Yay, you know?
I've already had a few myself. Why
so that's yummy.
This way?
And then for a side dish with this, I mean, I didn't have time to prepare it this morning, but I like to do a salad, a really fresh salad, even a panzanella salad.
Noodle,
go for it. You know, and add in a little bit. If I have some bread that's a few days old, you know, I'll slice it up, put it in the toaster oven with a little bit of EVOO.
You said
salt
panzanella
pepper.
Salad. If
yeah.
people are there, maybe that sounds a little unfamiliar. What is in a panzanella
sure,
salad?
Sure. A panzanella basically means that you're just adding in croutons and some sort of Italian ingredient. So we'll usually do tomatoes. We'll do some arugula if we have it around, and then a really light Italian dressing. And
it plays well because you already have sun-dried tomatoes in the pasta.
Now,
too, in the
I'm doing my best here. How am I doing?
You're doing a great job.
Okay, because I know I don't want to be too aggressive with it, but I also want to make sure that we're doing what it is we need to do.
Perfect. You're mixing everything together, and you're making that sauce happen. And
I like to call this the under-over move, lose noodles in the process.
No, but that's fine. And obviously, it's not meant to be a perfect dish. It's rustic.
Because it's called the Monday Mess.
Monday Mess.
Exactly. I'm just doing my part.
So we can. This looks good, Mikhaila. What do you think?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
So we got a little bit of liquid in there, but that's okay.
And that's fine. And if you know, I forgot to mention, but we did leave a little bit of pasta water in the bowl as well. So that has a starch from the pasta
Chef
in
Lexi,
there.
I'm ready.
That thickens it up. Thank you so much. So we'll give you guys a little plate here, and we'll put it all together.
Nice. Do you need the
Yeah, maybe that spoon, Brenden.
Yeah, perfect.
What kind of assistant am I?
Jeez. That's perfect.
Good luck getting Chef Lexi to come back.
And this is good, too, because, I mean, look at the amount that you have, whether you're cooking for four people, even two people. I mean, I'm someone who loves leftovers, so doing this Monday night, now you got dinner for Tuesday, too.
Exactly. You can bring it for lunch. It's not even bad cold, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You can do it as a bit of a pasta salad.
Here, I'll give it a sprinkle of cheese
perfect.
To top
Thank
it
you.
Off.
Look at that.
Gorgeous.
Yum.
Lexi, not only do you
That's
do
awesome.
A fabulous job day in and day out assisting us with the production of The Road Show, you are a master chef, and we thank you for jumping into action here today.
Thank you so much. It's so fun to cook, and I hope that, you know, after the show, we all cook together sometimes, hoping to do it again.
Doesn't even look like a mess. It looks
I'm
delicious.
I'm looking forward to an invite to eat at your house that you mentioned earlier. Okay, if you would like Chef Lexi's recipe for her Monday Mess, soon to be trademarked, you know what to do. Just head on over to our website. It's roadshow.com.